Overview of the normal table. The normal table allows us to find probabilities for continuous random variables rather than using calculus. The normal table is literally a table of probabilities based on values of z-scores. The z-scores shown on the table range from negative 3.49 to positive 3.49. The first column shows the ones in the tens digit, and so if you look here at the z, you can see that it goes from negative 3.4, again, that's the ones in the tens digit, and as we look to the other side of the page, we have the positive z-scores, and they, again, range from negative 3.49 to positive 3.49. So the first column shows us the ones in the tens digit, and the first row tells us the hundredths digit. And so that's why we know it goes from negative 3.49 to positive 3.49. Although z-scores can range from negative infinity to positive infinity, the z-scores in the normal table only range from negative 3.49 to positive 3.49 because the empirical rule tells us that 99.7% of the observations will fall within 3 standard deviations of the mean. Therefore, we don't really need to count out 20 standard deviations. Just counting out 3 standard deviations would be sufficient. So if we want to use this table to find probabilities, we first need to convert our information from scenarios to a z-score, and then using the actual z-scores, we can find the corresponding probabilities. So for example, once we convert to a z-score and we obtain a value, a negative 1.75, we would go down to negative 1.7 and then over to 5. And this probability corresponds to a z-score of negative 1.75. Suppose we had a z-score of negative 2.18. We would go to negative 2.1, then over to 8. Again, the very first row tells us the hundredths digit. So negative 2.1 and then over to 8. And this value is the probability that corresponds to a z-score of negative 2.18. Suppose we had a z-score of positive 3.26. Again, the left side of the table are the negative z-scores and the right side are the positive. So we'll go to 3.2 and then over to 6. And this probability corresponds to a z-score of positive 3.26. The probability shown in the table corresponds to the area to the left of the z-score. So you can see here, it's always the area to the left of the z-score. The probabilities are also cumulative. So beginning with a z of negative 3.49, so at negative 3.49, you can see the probability is 0.0002. And the probabilities, again, are cumulative. So they add to the previous area until we get to a total area of 1. And therefore, the area to the left of negative 3.49 is 0.0002. But once we get to positive 3.49, we have 0.9998, which is approximately 1. So recall that the total area under the curve is 1, and since the probabilities are only related to area that's to the left of the z-score, in order to find area to the right of the z-score, we have to perform an extra step. So again, the table only tells us area to the left. To find area to the right of the z-score, you're going to subtract that probability from 1. So now that I have shown an overview of the normal table, let's explore some examples.